Okay, this video we're going to go how to outline an essay. So let's jump into an outline here. We've already done this in last week where we broke things down into topic sentence, major and minor detail. Come on, there we go. All right. So we read this about television. TV violence does affect people in negative ways. Here we have the main idea, the topic sentence, major, minor, major, minor, major, minor, and then we would add a closing here because a paragraph by itself should have a closing sentence. Now, if this paragraph were part of an essay, then sometimes you don't need a closing sentence because your reader knows that the paragraph's going to continue, or sometimes it just flows seamlessly. But if you have a paragraph standing by its own, it should have a closing sentence. Okay, so this is an outline, and then we had another outline here. So here what they're doing is we read ours and then we broke it down. What they're saying is you could do the same thing, but opposite. Start the outline and then write the paragraph from it. Okay. So we're on Ben's. So his points about soft addictions, that's the topic sentence. And then here's the support. These would be the legs of the table. So instead of having four, we have three. And these are considered major details. And if you notice, one, another, these are addition words or clues. They help us map it out for our readers. They can follow it more easily. And then we have three major details here. Let's see. The notice, oh, I love this. This is really good. This is going to help you guys. And this is in your book too. So you may want to make a copy of this or just take a picture of this because I think it's really good. So notice that he took his paragraph and he took each of these major details and look, one, two, three. Drinking coffee is a common part. Instead of being a major detail, now it's become a topic sentence. And in this paragraph, it will have its own major details, like drinking coffee, watching TV. It's its topic sentence, and now it will have major details to support the topic sentence. Do you see how these major details became their own topic sentences for an essay paragraph? And then, instead of being the major detail, they will now have their own major details to support them because they are topic sentences now. So we have the intro. Drinking coffee, watching TV, using the internet, and then the closing paragraph. Okay, let's review of topic and topic sentences. All right. You can go through that. I have my own way of doing it. So here, let's go through. So here are some examples of topics and possible topic sentences. So the topic is cold versus flu. That's the topic. What are we going to learn about cold versus flu? That will be the controlling idea. Let me write that there. Controlling idea. Oh, I'm writing with my mouse. Controlling. You guys are like, dude. Controlling idea. Or my writing is out of control. So you have the topic and then the controlling idea. These two things make the topic sentence. So the flu has some very specific symptoms that make it different from a cold. So cold versus flu, or I could just say cold and flu are the topics. What are we going to learn? We're going to learn how they differ. So that's the controlling idea. Let's go down here. Texting. What are we going to learn about texting? Texting is the topic. There are certain times when you should definitely not text. So texting is the topic. What do they want us to learn about texting? When not to do it. That would be the controlling idea. Doctor visit topic. What are we going to learn about a doctor visit? So if you're prepared, do a few simple preparations. Okay. So topic sentence, the doctor visit. What does the author want us to learn? Some simple preparations. Maybe take a list of questions with yourself. Maybe write down the medications that you're taking. College stress. What about college stress? Let's see. Attending college can be more stressful than many incoming students realize. So college stress is the topic. What are we going to learn about it? That it's more stressful than some people realize. And then the essay will tell us about that. Okay, staying on point. Don't go off point. You have to be relevant. Let's take a look here. You want to stay on target. You want to be relevant. Okay. Stay on point. You don't want to be irrelevant, and I hope they give some good examples here, because that'll just throw it off. You don't want to be off topic or off point. Don't miss the target. All right, here's a point that could be developed in a paragraph. My sister should break up with her boyfriend. He speaks rudely to her in front of his friends. Speaking rudely to her friends, is that a reason she should break up with him? Yes, I think this is relevant. So this statement is relevant because it's talking about why she should break up with him. It's a good reason. Okay. They have been dating more than 2 years. Okay. What does it have to do with her breaking up? We need more information. To me, this is off topic. It's irrelevant, or they'll have to add more facts to it. Okay. He says nasty things to her. Is that a reason she should break up with him? Yeah, it's relevant. It's on target. Okay, good. He is studying to be a certified public accountant. Okay, to me, this is off topic. It's not saying why she should break up with him. Now, if the author were to say he's studying to be a certified public and ignores her, or, you know, doesn't devote time to her anymore, or is so obsessed with it that he's neglecting his girlfriend, which is your sister, well, then I think that would be relevant. But the way it is here, it's not relevant. It's off topic. It has nothing to do with breaking up, why she should break up. Unless, again, we added more information to it. His parents are good friends with our parents. Is that a reason to break up? I don't think so. I think it's off topic. So. Number six, he often disappears for long periods and won't tell her where he's been. Yeah, definitely break up with him quickly. He sounds like a loser. So it's definitely relevant. So if that were happening to my daughter, I would kick him to the curb. All right. So statement six is relevant. So if you take a look, 1, 3, and 6, they're all giving reasons why she should break up with him. 2, 4, and 5 are just too vague. They're off topic. Providing enough support. You want to have enough specifics. Okay. Good. Strong, specific support. Notice how the legs got. They're too vague. So your topic sentence is going to be weak. Your table is going to be weak. Strong, specific. Okay, so let's take a look here. Read these, and then we'll talk about them. So if you take a look, the topic sentence is, my grandmother had a hard childhood. So the topic is my grandmother. What are we going to learn about it? She had a hard childhood. So we're going to explain or describe how she had a hard childhood. So this would be the controlling idea. A is good, but B is more specific. So it's more interesting to the reader. Okay, so you can see, so it lacks sharp details, it's vague and dull, and then B, specific details, good. Now, it's not in the video, but take a look here. She worked in a textile mill for 10 hours. She slept on a mattress. She used the outhouse, and she ate greasy roasted squirrel. We have 4 major details here. Now, if we wanted to turn this into an essay, how many body paragraphs would we have? 4, one for each of these. How long would the paragraph be? 6. We'd have the introduction, 1, 2, 3, 4 body paragraphs, and then the conclusion. Okay. So go ahead and read these over, a paragraph, think of the table. The topic sentence is being held up. An essay is a bunch of paragraphs put together, and instead of having a topic sentence for the essay has a central point, or I call it a thesis. To me, a thesis, don't make it hard on yourselves, is a topic sentence on steroids. It's on steroids because it has more information to cover. We'll delve into thesis statements more, probably in 2 weeks. An outline helps us plan it out. If you can plan it out nicely, it'll help you write it better. I don't usually write an outline, but when I'm driving, I'll put stuff in my, you know, I'll organize my essays while I'm driving or doing something. Okay. The topic is the general subject. The topic sentence is the idea about the, so the topic sentence again to me is the topic and then what we're going to learn. What we're going to learn about that topic is the controlling idea. Stay on point. Make sure you're relevant. If you're talking about your grandmother's house and then all of a sudden you're talking about going to Applebee's, that's off topic. It's irrelevant. Okay. Unless you're comparing, like, at my grandmother's house, we get really good meals versus eating at Applebee's. That way it's connected. But if it's not connected to the main point, it's off topic. It's irrelevant. Okay. And then you want to have specific details. Don't make them so vague. You want to have make them specific and strong. It makes them stronger. Okay. Thanks, everybody.